I recommend that. There's some films.
I said, I can't even remember this phrase. I said, yeah. CM.
It's the right one.
So you still singing?
The car alone.
Because you know we've got extra seats up here for Sundays.
Busy.
Mentioning something about you, you know, saving somebody's life with like procedures, CPR,
mountain climbing,
right?
Exactly. Yep.
Good to see you too.
Kindly make sure that you silence all your cell phones and turn off all alarms so that we will not be disturbed during our celebration of the Mass. Kindly make sure that you silence all your cell phones and turn off all alarms so that we will not be disturbed during our celebration of the Mass. In a few moments, we shall begin our Eucharistic celebration, remembering 1 year of the passing and the departure of our beloved Mami Yason from this life to eternal life with God, our loving Father in heaven. So let's now all stand.
In a few moments, we shall begin.
And move into the silence of our hearts.
Eucharistic celebration, remembering 1 year of the passing and the departure of our beloved Mami Yason from this life to eternal life with God, our loving.
Holy name.
end draws near and my time has come. Still my soul will sing your praise unending. 10,000 years and forevermore.
Bless the Lord, O my soul,
O my soul.
Worship His holy name. Sing like never before.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father, who raised Jesus from the dead, be always with you.
And with your spirit, Father.
Gathered in this celebration, we take a moment to open our hearts and our lives to our compassionate God, who forgives us our sins and gives us the grace to restore us. Lord Jesus, you are the resurrection and the life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You bring pardon and peace to us. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You lead our departed loved ones into the eternal life in heaven. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Into your hands, O Lord, we humbly entrust our beloved sister, Mami Ason. In this life, you embraced her with your tender love. Deliver her now from every evil, and bid her enter eternal rest. The old order has passed away. Welcome her then into paradise, where there will be no sorrow, no weeping nor pain, but the fullness of peace and joy with your Son and the Holy Spirit forever and ever.
Amen.
Kindly all be seated to listen to God's word.
A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. There is an appointed time for everything, and a time for every affair under the heavens. A time to give birth, and a time to die. A time to plant, and a time to uproot the plant. A time to kill, and a time to heal. A time to tear down, and a time to build. A time to weep, and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to scatter stones and a time to gather them. A time to embrace and a time to be far from embraces. A time to seek and a time to lose. A time to keep and a time to cast away. A time to rend and a time to sow. A time to be silent and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time of war and a time of peace. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I turn to you, Lord. Time of trouble, and you fill me with the joy of salvation. I turn to you, Lord, in times of trouble, and you fill me with the joy of salvation. Blessed is he whose fault is taken away, whose sin is covered. Bless the man to whom the Lord imputes not guilt, whose spirit there is no guile. I turn to you, Lord, in times of trouble, and you fill me with the joy of salvation. And I acknowledge my sin to you, my guilt I cover not. I said I confess my thoughts to the Lord, and you took away the guilt of my sin. I turn to you, Lord, in time of trouble, and you fill me with the joy of salvation. Be glad in the Lord. Rejoice, rejoice, you just exalt all you upright of heart. I turn to you, Lord, in time of trouble, and you fill me with the joy of salvation. I turn to you, Lord, in time of trouble, and you fill me with the joy of salvation.
Reading from the letter of Paul to the Romans. None of us lives for oneself, and no one dies for oneself. For if we live, we live for the Lord, and if we die, we die for the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. For this is why Christ died and came to life, that he might be the Lord of both the dead and the living. Why then do you judge your brother? Or you, why do you look down on your brother? For we shall all stand before the judgment seat of God. For it is written, as I live, says the Lord, every knee shall bend before me, and every tongue shall give praise to God. So then each of us shall give an account of himself to God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. At that time, Jesus answered, I give praise to you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for although you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned, you have revealed them to the childlike. Yes, Father, such has been your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart, and you will find rest for yourselves, for my yoke is easy and my burden light. The Gospel of the Lord. Kindly be seated for a while. In my first assignment here at the Diocese of Orange, I came upon a family, and they just recently lost a sister, the mother of a little girl named Kiara. And the family told me, that said, Father, my sister left my niece to us, and sometimes when she looks for her, we tell her that she is in heaven, her mom is in heaven. And if she looks up, then she'll see her mom, and her mom can see her. And if she speaks to her in her heart, then her mom will hear her. One time, I was in their house, I forgot for what occasion, and suddenly I saw Kiara running outside and looking up. So I said, Kiara, what are you doing? I'm talking to mommy. And I said, why? Why do you need to talk to mommy? Oh, because daddy was being mean to me and I'm telling mommy about it. Sometimes in the face of death, we feel lost because we are helpless. We can neither prevent it and neither we can ever stop it from happening because that's part of our human existence. One philosopher once said that the moment you live, you start dying. You just don't know when or where it is. Like I said in my homily last Sunday, every life has a beginning, a middle, and an end. We are here to celebrate that first part of that life of Mami Yason, a life that she lived mostly with you, her family, and those who are joining us in our celebration through live stream. And this was a life that she lived to the best of her ability, especially as a mother. And as a mother, she made sure that her children received the best of what she can ever give together with her husband. And what's left of us during these moments of helplessness, when we can no longer see, nor touch, nor hear in the familiar places with our physical eyes, our loved one, sometimes we say the lost, but the loss is not entirely theirs because they're not lost. They're with God. And we know exactly where they are and exactly where we will meet when our own journey ends in this life. But we are the ones that are at the lost. But God gave us a beautiful gift, the gift of memory, the gift of having that memory and having that relationship, not severed, but taken to a different level, a level that's no longer bound by time nor physical space, because it is a connection made with love, a love that we all feel with our departed loved ones, and a love that will connect us and one day reunite us with them when, like them, they are called into that union with that divine perfect love in heaven. In the meantime, what we have are treasured memories. And I'm pretty sure in the past year, there have been a flood, there have been times where you reminisce, there are times that you were reminded about certain circumstances, situations, incidents. Personally, if I can share, every time I see green, I would always be reminded of my mom because she loved the color green. And sometimes I ask her, what are you telling me? Honestly, there's never been a Christmas that I have not seen anybody wearing green because it's a Christmas color, right? But the thing is, there's that connection that keeps the person truly alive in our hearts and that keeps our relationship more firm and more solid and more meaningful and significant. So this time, we'll take a moment of one of the things that perhaps we can ask God to fill our hearts with is the feeling and the grace of gratitude, thanking God for the gift of the person of our mommy and son, thanking God that she has touched our lives, your lives, and that she has left something that will be part of who you are and part and parcel of your life as we all continue in our journey. So we have a video of the grandkids sharing who Mami Ason is to them. And parcel of your life as we all continue in our journey. So we have a video of the grandkids sharing who Mami Ason is to them.
Thank you, Lola, for being so selfless and for planning ahead for your grandchildren.
Thank you, Lola, for showing that you always care, even if that means waking up at 3 a.m. and giving me cereal when I wake up.
Son, for your humility, your love, and your generosity. We'll miss you.
Thank you, Lola, for showing that you always care, even if that means waking up at 3 a.m. and giving me cereal.
Thank you, Lola, for all of your sacrifices, for all of the life lessons that you have taught me.
Thank you, Lola, son,
and for your everlasting
your
love.
Humility, your love, and your generosity.
Thank you, Lola, for reminding us to always love a lot, but always eat more.
Thank you, Lola, for all of your sacrifices, for all of the life lessons that you have taught me, and for your everlasting love.
Thank you, Lola, for all of the love and sacrifices you made to build a family that we can always call home.
Thank you, Lola, for reminding us to always love a lot. Always eat more.
Thank you, Lola, for always bringing the family together, no matter how far away.
Thank you, Lola, for your dedication to your family, for your unwavering love, patience, and support. Thank you for being a beacon of resilience and strength.
Thank you, Lola, for always bringing the family together.
Thank you, Lola, for always having Hershey's Kisses on you when you pick my brother and I up from school.
Thank you, Lola, for teaching me that famine always comes first.
Thank you for being
Thank you, Lola, for always being first.
Thank you, Lola, for always having Hershey's Kisses on you when you pick my brother and I up from school.
Thank you, Lola, for showing us by your example how to keep our loved ones close, no matter how far apart we are.
Thank you, Lola, for teaching me that family.
Thank you, Lola, for bringing our parents into this world, making it possible for us to be in this world.
Thank you, Lola, for leading by example, showing us how to both raise a family and run several successful businesses.
when we feel that our loved ones who have departed and gone home to the Father are too far away, there is the shortest bridge that we can take, and that is the bridge of prayer. So when we gather at the Eucharist, when we even pray and move into our hearts, that's where we will encounter our loved ones, and that's where the love becomes truly felt, real, and meaningful. So let's reflect on this song about prayer and about the gift and value that I believe Mami Ason has left with everyone.
La luce che tu dai,
I pray we'll find your light,
nel cuore resterà,
and hold it in our hearts,
a ricordarci che,
when stars go out each night,
l'eterna stella sei.
Faith, so we'll be saved.
Ella,
Let us now all stand for the prayers of the faithful. Dear friends, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church, confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus. We join our prayers to his.
Your response will be, Lord, hear our prayer.
Hear our prayer.
For Corazon Abelia Columna, who in baptism given the pledge of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of the saints, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Corazon, who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that she may be raised up on the last day, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our deceased relatives and friends, and for all those who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who trusted in the Lord, now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
The family and friends of Corazon seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together in God's kingdom, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Kindly all be seated for the liturgy of the Eucharist.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant, our beloved Mami Ason, may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end. We acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Kevin, our Bishop, Timothy, Thomas, and Todd, his brother bishops, all the bishops, priests, deacons, religious, and all your faithful people. Remember your servant, our beloved Mommy, a son whom you have called from this world to yourself, grant that she who was united with your son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Santiago de Compostela, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit, Father.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Peace be with you. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Thank you.
out of excuses. Lord, it's hard to know you. I don't always see your plan. But holiness is calling me, so take me as I am. As you are my everything, you are the song I sing. I'll do anything for you. Teach me how to pray, live a life of grace. I'll go anywhere with you. Jesus, be my everything. Lord, I get so tired of the struggle within. I settle in complacency and I'm weighed down in my sin. So lead me past emotion. Change with the wind. I want to be a true disciple to daily choose your hand. You are my everything. You are the song I sing. I'll do anything for you. Teach me how to pray. Life of grace, I'll go anywhere with you. Jesus, be my everything. Jesus, be my everything.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant, our beloved Mami Ason, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal Sacrament, may forever live into the dwelling place of light, joy, peace, and love. Through Christ our Lord. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto our beloved Mami Ason, O Lord.
And let perpetual light shine upon her.
May she rest in peace.
Amen.
May her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace.
Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. And may Almighty God bless all of you and your loved ones, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We have celebrated the life and the 1 year since the departure of our beloved Mami Ason to heaven. Let us go bearing in our hearts God's love, hope, and peace. Thanks be to God. Have a blessed evening, everyone.